Just imagine, you receive your brand new 60% split keyboard connected and happily start typing away. Suddenly, you want to move the cursor up to fix a typo, and then you realize, where are the arrow keys? Wait, and the function keys? In most 60% keyboards, those keys are accessible with a special function key. The problem is that the function key is usually not customizable, so you're stuck with how it's configured. The function key is also quite challenging to reach, making everything uncomfortable. If you have a programmable keyboard like the Digma Race 2 or the Digma Defy, you can tweak your layout to improve the way you use arrows or function keys. Let's start with the arrow keys, as this is the feature that most people miss when switching to a 60% keyboard. By default, in our keyboards, these keys are under ESDF on layer 2, which you can access by pressing a thumb key on either side. Personally, that's the most comfortable way to use arrow keys. You press a thumb key and then navigate with the keys near your home row. But I can understand why it might be a lot to process at first. Let's see how you can have arrow keys on the primary layer. If you have a Digma Race 2, the easiest way to do that is to change the right-hand modifiers for an arrow cluster. It can be on an inverted T or in a row. The problem with this solution is that you lose access to those modifiers on the right. Nonetheless, there's a way to have arrows and modifiers using superkeys. With superkeys, you can assign the arrows to tap and the modifiers to hold. The only drawback is that if you need to move the cursor or an image a long way, you can't hold the arrows. You need to do multiple taps. If you have a Digma Defy, you can do something similar by creating an arrow cluster using the thumb keys. However, as I mentioned, I believe using a dedicated layer for arrows is the best approach. It opens up a world of possibilities. For example, I have regular arrows on my left hand, but with my right hand, I can move the cursor jumping words or take it to the beginning or the end of the line. But there are many possibilities. Some prefer the arrows in the bottom right or on HJKL. Your imagination is the limit. Imagine all the arrows. Let's move on to the function keys. By default, these are on the number row on layer 3, which you can also access by pressing a thumb key on either side. If you use function keys a lot, I think this could be improved. For example, you could have a layer fully dedicated to function keys, where they are placed in the home row. No need to reach for the number row. Plus, you could add more rows of function keys combined with modifiers. But if you want to have function keys on the main layer, don't worry. Superkeys come to the rescue again. You can create one superkey with the number on top and the function key on hold, and assign those to your number row. That way, they'll be in a more familiar spot. You only need to hold the number to get the equivalent function key. F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, and so on. And that's it. That's some of the ways you can use arrows and function keys on your 60% keyboard. We'd love to hear how you have them set up in the comments below. Bye! Imagine all the arrows living in harmony.